Hello, my dear students. How are you all? Welcome back once again. This is your English teacher Himanshi ma'am. I hope you people are staying safely at home and nobody is getting out. And students, I know that currently you all are very much occupied in completing your holiday homeworks as well as your project works of all the subjects given to you. But today I want to take this time and remind you once again that you not only have to fill up the pages and complete your project. No, what you have to do is you have to understand the topic. You have to take some interest in finding out information related to that topic. Beta, when I receive your project work of English and I read your name and then I flip the pages, I should feel impressed that okay, this student has done this kind of research. Especially I will be very impressed by the students who will be able to find out new and latest informations related to the topics which are given to you. Well, of course you have to choose only one topic for your project, so I'm sure that is going to be interesting. The most important point is that you have to take interest in your work. Don't take it as a burden. Don't take it as a load of written work which you will just finish off and close. No. Take your time. Utilize your time. Do it nicely. Take interest. Discuss the topic with your siblings. Discuss that topic with your parents. I'm sure your parents will be able to give you a lot of information which you might not know earlier. Talk to them. It should be a topic of discussion on dinner table in your family. That will be the best output of that project work when you will be choosing and doing it. Coming back to your revision video, this is going to be your revision video number 4 for class 8th. I'm repeating, this video is only going to be for class 8 students. And what have we done in the previous revision videos? Beta, whatever we have done before the summer vacation started, we are revising all those things in brief only with you and me. In the previous revision videos, I have given you the recap of course book, 3 chapters, and grammar, 1 chapter. So what is left? Let me think. Well, your writing section is still remaining. So I think we should utilize this time to take a revision of notice writing as well as email writing. That's right. In writing section, I have done 2 topics with all my students. So today, let us do a quick and short recap of both the things together so that you all can get back to doing your project work also. Am I right? So students, once again, have a look at your screens. I will be posting a few things and I hope this revision will be useful to you. Because I know students have this habit that once the chapter is over, they don't go look back into it again. They always keep on moving to the next and newer things. But it is always important that before we move on to the new thing, we have to make sure that we remember the previous things nicely. Okay students, time to look at the screen. Revision of writing section. Notice writing. It is a format of writing a small piece of information within a box for public display. It is mostly written for events, lost and found items, or any general announcements. Email writing. It is a format of communicating digitally with one or more persons at a time by sending or responding in brief. It can be used for both personal and professional work. It always requires an email ID. Some points to remember. A notice is always written in a box. Every notice requires date, time, and venue. Person who writes the notice is called undersigned. Always give designation to undersigned. An email should be written in brief. Long paragraphs should be avoided. Greetings must be there. Now students, as you all can see on your screens, it is the revision for format of notice writing. There is a big rectangular box and inside the box all the content is present. In the middle, we have 3 headings, name of the school, notice in capital letters, and then heading of the content. On the left hand margin, we have the date of issuing notice
and then in the content we will give answer to questions like what, where, when, who and how, and any additional information. And last, signature. For example, you can write for further information contact undersigned. And at last, you write the name and designation of the person who is writing the notice. Another question for revision. As you can see on your screen, if you will pause the video and read the content written, you will understand and it will be a good recap of notice writing. You can see how in brief and precise manner the content is written, the format is followed properly, and you can see the last line, for further details contact undersigned. This line I want all my students to remember always while writing any kind of notice. It is a very important and a very attractive point in notice writing. And always make the box in the last. After you have finished writing everything, you should make the box, as it helps you make a good structure for your answer. Now, another sample of email writing. Write an email to your bank's branch and request for a new credit card as your previous one got damaged recently. So students, with the help of this question, let us revise the format of email writing. First, we have two, that means the receiver's email ID. CC and BCC columns will be left empty. Subject is always written in short and crispy words. Then we come to the main content. We start with the greetings, dear sir or madam. Now let us look at the content. This is to bring to your notice that I am a certificate account holder. Students, when you will read the content, you can pause the video also. You will see that the content is short and very much to the point. After finishing the main information, in the last we give a salutation, thank you in advance. And again in the end, yours faithfully, name or any other detail etc. which you want to add in. So students, this was your revision of writing section, both the topics.
So students, this was for your revision video number 4. I hope this revision was easy and understood by all of you nicely. And I hope that you all are doing your project work with dedication and interest and learning new things, okay? And most importantly, in today's video lesson, please give me an update. All my dear students who have been actively talking to me through the comment box, please give me an update on your work. Tell me how much work you are doing. Tell me which topic you have chosen. I am very much curious. You know, I keep scratching my head and keep thinking that out of those 5 topics, which topic you have selected. So in today's video lesson, what are you going to do? You're going to give me an update on how much work you have completed, or whether you have just started, or whatever you are doing. If you are not even doing English yet, maybe you are on some other subject right now. So just give me an update and I will be very interested to know which topic you, my students, have finally selected. And I hope after finishing your project work, you will definitely do the revision of the chapters we have completed before summer vacation, so that whenever we come back to the syllabus after this vacation period, I will be able to get good answers from all of you. So students, that's all for today's revision video. When are we going to meet next? I'm going to meet all of you again on Saturday in the WebEx class. Make sure you all attend it and be there. Okay students, I hope to see you all soon, and don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Okay students, make sure you like this video, huh? Now please write in the comment box of today's video with your name, class and section. Okay students, I'll be waiting for your answers. Bye bye, take care.